is based on this spiritual reality that you and each and every one of us ought to live on a daily basis as Orthodox Christians. But how much more we who have been called, who have accepted this calling and invitation, and who have responded to Christ by saying and repeating that which the Virgin Mother, the Holy Theotokos, responded and she said, "In vui 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 I will pursue that which is your will. And it is this will of God which must overtake every form and reaction of our life itself. It is the will of God which ought to be pursued by you, by me, and by all of us. But how much more are we responsible for the spiritual cultivation of this will of God in the lives and the hearts of the people who are entrusted to our care? You are being made a deacon. God calling you today to be ordained ambassador of the church and priest. Will you have been granted the blessing and the sacred opportunities to find the ways with which this gospel which you have chosen to offer, how you will be lived by your people? This is a tremendous challenge of the day. But this is a challenge that same as a failure, to whom the meditative author was made aware. This is the same challenge that same as a failure is accepting at a very, very early age, being ordained a deacon at the age of 15, and a bishop, a hierarch of the church at 20. Now some people will say, well, this is terrible. Only my advice to theologians are educate yourselves. Because at that time, canons were not written yet. So you have the unwritten law, and you have the written law as a hierarch of the church, my friends. I eternally advise you to keep both the laws in consideration. Both the laws in consideration. And to live by both the laws with faith and discernment. If a clergyman does not know and does not experience and does not have to express itself with discernment, then we are failing. There are no two situations which must be dealt with the same way. Discernment, faith, love, and respect. You are not being ordained, and you will not enter the service of the Lord in the church, and most especially in the Metropolitan, if you do not discern, and if you have as the intent of your life, your personal legal company church, so when you go to have your way to put the feet around and say to your father, say, I am the priest. It doesn't work that way. I know so and so and so and so. The answer is good. But is it good for the people of God who have been entrusted to your care? Is it good for the growth of the church? Is it good for the spiritual foundations which have been laid by Christ and by the spiritual fathers who have preceded us? Is this foundation solid? And are you prepared to step upon a solid foundation, okay, which will help you rise, save your soul, Save thyself first, my friend, and then save others. Practice what you preach. Without expecting others to be blindly obedient to your quality of work. Be obedient yourself to the message of the gospel. Then, preach. Offer your love. Serve. Love the Lord. I will be there for you. I will have you here today. Every day of your meeting with God. Will be ensured that this conference radio and the conference and your world. Because of the creation of the public, I have an obligation for love and for you. I have an obligation to help cultivate your soul according to where you unceasingly will grow out of Him, not me. We glorify Him like that. We glorify Him and thank Him for that which you have become. Thank you, Lord, for the Christian who has been blessed and has been blessed with this call, serving Him as the celebrant of the mystery of God. It's resonating from my heart. Can I challenge you, my friend, to remain faithful, to remain dedicated, to remain a loving Christian, loving spouse, loving father, to devote his son, to both the parents and the universe,